Number 12, razor fish. This fish is most popularly known for adopting a head-down, tail-up position as an adaptation for hiding among sea urchin spines. The fact that it hides among sea urchins gives a clue as to its natural habitat, as it likes to stay in beds of seagrass and coral reefs where sea urchins are found. When it comes to appearance, the razorfish's strange shape easily gives it away. It's a small fish with a maximum size of 6 inches. Found in coastal waters in the Indo-West Pacific, the razorfish likes to eat small brine fish, small invertebrates, and tiny crustaceans. As if that selection of food isn't enough for the razorfish, it likes to eat its own young as well. The male razorfish cozies up to the female by pretending to be ready to mate. Then, once the female releases the eggs for external fertilization to take place, it gobbles them up and bolts away. Number 11. Egyptian mouth brooder. Very little information is available on the Egyptian mouth brooder. It is a species of cichlid, just like tilapia. The Egyptian mouth brooder is so named because it practices a form of childcare known as mouth brooding. This is also known as oral incubation or buccal incubation. Mouth brooding is a form of parental care in which the young are kept in a parent's mouth for an extended period of time to protect them from outside threats. While an effective parenting strategy, it also sets up cannibalism, which the Egyptian mouth brooder is fond of partaking in. Female Egyptian mouth brooders typically hold eggs in their mouth rather than live young. When too many of the eggs die, she simply consumes the rest. This makes sense biologically, as the dead eggs replenish her energy. By letting them out, they would likely be consumed by some other organism. Egyptian mouth brooders average 3 inches in length and can typically be found in rivers, lakes, and other freshwater habitats in eastern Africa, from Egypt, and as far south as Tanzania. Number 10. Dark fishing spider. The dark fishing spider is native to North America. Though it typically runs away from humans, it has been known to bite. However, the bite of the dark fishing spider is hardly more dangerous than that of a bee or wasp, meaning that in the absence of any hypersensitivity on part of the victim, the bite will merely be a nuisance. Bodies of female members of the species are about 1 inch long, with males being half that size. Legs of either gender range from 2 inches to about 3.5 inches. The dark fishing spider is pale brown to dark brown in color, with several chevron markers and lighter stripes around its legs. The legs are covered with black and brown bands. These spiders are found in wooded areas, and they dwell on trees. After males mate with females, they give up their bodies for the females to feed up. This sustenance ensures that the female has enough strength to lay eggs successfully. Sometimes, the males don't choose to do this, but females, being bigger, hunt them down either way. Number 9. Parasitic wasps. Their cannibalism is the least creepy thing about them. They are unique for having the second largest brood of any parasite insect, at 3,055 individuals. It is a cosmopolitan species that is distributed worldwide. It also has large agricultural significance due to its ability to control pests. Parasitic wasps have a weird way of breeding. To breed, an adult wasp will look for an unsuspecting caterpillar, paralyze it with her sting, and then inject one male egg and female egg into its body. As if that isn't weird enough, the eggs clone themselves until the same caterpillar contains thousands of them. Now, this is where cannibalism comes in. Once these eggs hatch, some of the females are born with extremely large jaws and no reproductive organs. Their only objective is to consume as many males as possible. After all, only a few males are needed for mating to take place. Number 8. Gilthead bream. Sometimes called orata or dorada, the gilthead sea bream is found in the Mediterranean Sea and the eastern coastal regions off of the North Atlantic Ocean. It is one of the best-tasting species of the bream group. It features heavily in Mediterranean cuisine. When it comes to size and appearance, the length of the gilthead bream can range between 1.15 feet and 2.3 feet. It can also weigh up to 16.2 pounds and has a gold bar marking between its eyes, which is the source of its species name. Though this fish feeds mainly on shellfish, it has been known to consume some plant materials. Usually, when cannibalism is expressed in any species, it typically involves larger members of the species eating the smaller ones. However, gilthead breams form the exception. as larvae attack and devour their big brothers and sisters. Number 7. Dying Poison Dart Frogs. The dying poison dart frog is one of the largest species of poison dart frog. As it contains toxins that are used for self-defense, it is highly poisonous. The poison causes pain, stiffness, and cramping. As the name implies, the poison is also applied to darts to improve hunting. The dying poison dart frog is typically found in South America. It grows between 1 to 3 inches long. It tends to come in a variety of bright colors as well, signaling to potential predators that it might not be worth eating. Cannibalism among this species arises due to a logical parental choice. Instead of laying eggs in empty pools, they lay eggs in pools that have other developed members of the species. The logic here is that, since the pool already has other members of the species, it is conducive for life. Unfortunately, those individuals tend to feed on the eggs and larvae. Number 6. Hippopotamuses. This creature's reputation precedes it. It is a large, mostly herbivorous, semi-aquatic mammal and is known to be very aggressive. Every year across Africa, hippos kill an estimated 500 people, making them the world's deadliest mammal, after humans, and nearly twice as deadly as lions. Hippos are typically found in Africa. They are among the largest living land mammals, being only smaller than elephants and some rhinoceroses. Their length ranges between 9.5 feet to 17 feet. They can also weigh between 2,800 pounds to 3,300 pounds, about the weight of a Toyota Corolla. Hippopotamuses are herbivores. They need to eat 88 pounds of grass a night to survive. Nevertheless, cases of cannibalism have been observed among them. At the Kruger National Park in South Africa, one hippopotamus was spotted eating the carcass of one of its own kind. They usually resort to cannibalism when regular food is hard to find. Number 5. Tiger Salamander. The tiger salamander is so named because of its appearance. It typically has yellow stripes or spots covering a black body. It is one of the largest terrestrial salamanders in North America. It has a lifespan of around 12 to 15 years and can grow to a length between 6 to 8 inches. In spite of the fact that this creature is an amphibian, it typically prefers woodland and grassy habitats. As adults, they are almost exclusively terrestrial, returning to water only to breed. They are secretive creatures who spend most of their lives underground in burrows, making them difficult to spot. Although these tiger salamanders prefer a diet of small insects, snails, slugs, frogs, and worms, they tend to turn cannibalistic. This is usually triggered by the high presence of competition within the hunting grounds. Cannibalism is always preceded by physical changes, during which heads become larger and teeth become bigger. Number 4. Snails. These shelled gastropods need little introduction. They typically include sea snails, freshwater snails, and land snails. Land snails can grow up to 12 inches large. The majority of them are pomonates that have lungs and breathe air. Although they have a strong muscular foot, they use mucus to enable them to crawl over rough surfaces and keep their soft bodies from drying out. They are typically herbivorous and have been known to eat leaves, stems, soft bark, fruit, vegetables, fungi, and algae. Some species have been known to eat slugs. Snail cannibalism arises after laying eggs. The process drains them of calcium, and so to satisfy this need, they tend to feed on hatched eggs. However, if these egg shells are not enough to satisfy the craving, they tend to eat some of their eggs as well. Number 3. Polar bears. Polar bears are the largest extant land carnivore. Native to the Arctic Circle, males typically weigh 770 to 1,540 pounds, while females are half the size. They typically feed on seals and have a life expectancy of about 25 years. Polar bears are hypercarnivores, meaning that they can feed on anything. But even though they are traditionally known to be protective of their young, this is slowly changing. The melting of the polar ice caps has reduced the hunting area for these creatures. As such, when food is hard to come by, they can't stop themselves from eating their own kind. They typically prefer cubs, since the cubs can't defend themselves. However, males sometimes pick on females. Number 2. Freshwater shrimp. Not much is known about these shrimp. These shrimp only resort to cannibalism when they are ill. A parasite, about the size of a red blood cell, tends to infect these creatures, increasing their demand for food and other nutrients. Because of the presence of the parasite, these shrimp get so insanely hungry that they will resort to eating anything. As such, they feed on unsuspecting juveniles of the same species. Number 1. Sand tiger sharks. Also known as the gray nurse shark, spotted ragged-tooth shark, or blue nurse sand tiger, the sand tiger shark is a species of shark that inhabits subtropical and temperate waters worldwide. They have been known to dive as deep as 650 feet beneath the ocean surface. It is one of the most slow-moving sharks and has no confirmed human casualties. They typically range between 6.6 feet to 10.5 feet in length. They also typically weigh between 201 and 351 pounds, about the weight of a motorcycle. They tend to feed on fish and rays. Cannibalism in this species typically manifests among embryonic forms in the womb. This makes the embryos grow larger before they are born, giving them a better chance of surviving against predators. And since females typically mate with many males, embryos from the same male typically gang on embryos from another male. Would you rather fight a polar bear or a hippo? Let us know in the comments section below.